firefighting robot with RF controller. Introduction. The project is designed to develop a firefighting robot using RF technology for remote operation. The robotic vehicle is loaded with water tanker and a pump which is controlled over wireless communication to throw water. At the transmitting and using push buttons, commands are sent to the receiver to control the movement of the robot, either to move forward, backward, and left or right, etc. At the receiving end, three motors are interfaced to the microcontroller, where two of them are used for the movement of the vehicle and the remaining one to position the water jet of the robot. An 8051 series of microcontroller is used for the desired operation. Design. These images show the designs of all the parts of the robot and the assembled view of the robot. Major components. Supporting elements. Power supply controller. Motors. Pump. Batteries. Water tank. Wireless IP camera. Supporting element. There are four metal sheets which are bolted together to form a base for the robot, upon which the PCBs, water tank, and other accessories of the robot are placed. Water tank. The tank used for car windshield spraying is employed in the project. It has a capacity of 1.5 liters. Battery. 4 1.5-volt batteries is used to power the controller, and 2 6-volt batteries is coupled to supply power to the three motors and the pump. DC motor. A DC motor is an electric motor that runs on direct current, DC, electricity. In any electric motor, operation is based on simple electromagnetism. There are three motors employed in the robot. Two motors are used for the locomotion of the robot. One is employed for the positioning of the water spray nozzle. DC pump. A pump is a device that moves fluids or liquids and gases, sometimes slurries, by mechanical action. One pump is attached to the water tank and is driven by the 12 volts battery. It is used to spray water at high pressure through the nozzle. IP camera. An Internet Protocol camera, or IP camera, is a type of digital video camera commonly employed for surveillance, and which, unlike analog closed-circuit television CCTV cameras, can send and receive data via a computer network and the Internet. It is used to view the fire scenario in any smart devices. It is compatible with wide range of platforms. 8051 microprocessor. It is a low-voltage, high-performance CMOS 8-bit microcomputer with 2K bytes of flash programmable and erasable read-only memory. It serves as the heart of the robot by processing the received signals. It decodes the received signals and operates the robot as per the command received from the user end. Power regulator. 7085 is a voltage regulation IC, which is used to supply 5 volts direct current to the microcontroller. There is a separate power regulator unit for each of the motors, and it ensures that only the required power is supplied to the motors. There is a separate power regulator unit for the pump, which ensures its action at right time. RF module. This RF module comprises of an RF transmitter and an RF receiver. An RF transmitter receives serial data and transmits it wirelessly through RF through its antenna connected at pin 4. The transmitted data is received by an RF receiver operating at the same frequency as that of the transmitter. The RF module is often used along with a pair of encoder, decoder. The encoder is used for encoding parallel data for transmission feed, while reception is decoded by a decoder. Basic working. RF transmitter is present in the controller. It sends a unique frequency signal for each push button being pressed. RF receiver is placed in the PCB present in the robot, and it receives the signals from transmitter. The signal received is decoded by the 8051 microprocessor. The robot responds according to the decoded signal. Advantages: not sensitive to weather conditions. Prevents the loss of life of the firefighters. Can work continuously without any lag. Disadvantages: data rate transmission is lower than wire transmission. High cost. Communication devices mostly use similar frequency, so interference occurs if the address are not specified. Conclusion: thus, a firefighter robot is being built and it works in a satisfactory condition. The robot for now requires a human assistance to operate and put off the fire. The future scope of the project is to provide the robot with the sensors to detect the sensor by itself and put it off. Further, it can enhance by coupling it with fire alarms, which are usually placed in most of the buildings. Thank you.